श्रीगणेशगुरुश्रेष्ठौ ब्रह्मतत्त्वस्वरूपिणौ नत्वा वसिष्ठवाल्मीकिसिद्धिबुद्धिप्रदायकौ स्वजीवनेन जीवं यो जीवितुं पर्यदर्शयत् प्रणम्यते स रामो वै सततं योगतत्परः.
लॉर्ड रामा हैज बीन डिनाउंसिंग मेनी ऑफ द थिंग्स दैट वी कंसिडर एज इम्पॉर्टेंट इन लाइफ और वॉट वी थिंक लाइफ इज ऑल अबाउट लाइक enjoyments, wealth, longevity, concept of I and mine. In the 16th chapter of Vairagya Prakarana of Yoga Vasishtha, he goes on to talk about the mind. He is explaining to sage Vishwamitra why he is dejected, why he is dejected with his own life. The Lord says, one should serve noble persons, be with them, be of service to them. Else, mind becomes unstable. Only when you get to see noble persons, how they conduct themselves in their life, and also get to listen to them, then only there is a chance that the mind attains some amount of stability. The natural tendency of the mind is to go towards instability. A strong wind, how it pushes around a small feather, this is how the mind is pushed around aimlessly. The mind can't decide where it should go. It is always pushed around. Distance is not a constraint for the mind. Like how a hungry dog would get out of the neighborhood and would roam far and wide in search of food, the mind can also go anywhere. Any amount of imagination it can go to. Daydreaming, any amount it can do. First of all, very few people get what they want in life. Even if they get, for example, wealth, lot of wealth, even then, the mind will not be satisfied. The mind, its needs are like a piece of bamboo open at both ends. You know, those who dwell in the forest, the tribes, they use bamboo to collect honey. If you cut a bamboo slightly below the joint from one end and slightly above the next joint at the other end, then one end is open and the other end is closed. If you pour honey or water into this, it will stay because one end is closed, the lower end is closed. But if you have a bamboo in which both sides are open, then even if you keep on pouring water, it will never fill. This is how satisfaction of the mind also is. There is never a state, yes, I am satisfied, I don't need any more. A deer is taken away from its herd. You keep it tied up somewhere, it will never be happy, away from its own herd. The mind is also tied up. Mind is in captivity. The rope which has tied up the mind is desires. Like the deer, mind can never be happy when it is tied up with desires. The mind cannot stay independently. Mind is an organ. It is an internal organ. But it cannot sit minding its own business, even for a moment. There are some people who spend their whole day sitting under a tree in the neighborhood, always looking around. What is he doing? What is she doing? Where is he going? Where is she going? Why is he running? What is there in that bag? They keep on looking around. Their antenna keeps on rotating 360 degrees on and on and on. Not one moment of stillness. These are not of any concern to them. Still they do it. This is what mind also does. There are two terms used here. Alunata and Shirnata, referring to the gross organs like hands and legs, and subtle organs, the internal organs associated with thinking, intelligence and emotions. The mind cannot stay for one moment not thinking about these. Why is there pain in my leg? Why my eyes are burning? How can I keep my hair healthy? How do I reduce my tummy? Not only this, why am I like this? Why am I not able to focus? Why am I slow in studies? The list is huge. The mind keeps on wandering from one to the next, one to another. There is no sequence or order even. When the Kshirasagara was being churned, how the waves of milk, how the turbulence was being created, chaotic, without any order. In the sea, when you sit on the seashore and watch, there is apparently an order. The waves always come towards you. But the waves in the mind are not like that. This moment, it will think about Sensex fall. And the next moment, it would think about Vaikuntha. The third moment, it would think about the child's school bus coming late. You can't predict what is going to occupy the mind the next moment. Even when you are listening to this, your mind will be into various other things. It is chaotic. This mind can never find peace. It is not created to be peaceful. It is created in such a way that it should be restless. It should be miserable. Lord Rama says, I can't do anything about this mind. Whatever look like sweet, orderly waves, they themselves turn into a whirlpool later and drown me. Enthusiasm comes, energy comes that I should achieve this. But then the achievements themselves become the cause of misery. We see this. Some people get facilitated. They are given awards. But then another section of the society throws mud at them. This is what affects them more. 100 uploads and one mudslinging. That is where your mind would go. That is the nature of the mind. You get affected by that single mudslinging. It would look like even this award was meant to make you miserable. A deer, when it sees green grass at a distance, it simply leaps towards it, runs towards it. It doesn't even think for a moment, is there a pit ahead? Will I fall into a pit if I run without looking so fast? Those who want to achieve, this is what happens to them. They don't see the pits en route. When you are overpowered by desire and ambition, this is what happens. You will not even bother to look what you are doing, where you are heading, whether it is right or wrong. What are the consequences? It is all about desire and success. You don't bother about anything else. The Lord says, Shubhra Patam Achintayanna. Whether what you are doing, whether it will push you into Naraka, this also you don't see when you are overpowered by desire, ambition and obsession about success. This is the very nature of the mind. This turbulence, this aimless wandering is the nature of the mind. Pushing someone into action based on this turbulent is the nature of the mind. It can't be otherwise. Like a lion in a cage. The mind is like a lion in a cage. It can't stay still. Have you seen the expression on the face of the lion in a cage? It is worried. It is not peaceful. That is why it is not able to sit still.
Ramaya Namaha.
Yajnanishre Kadamankarma.